Let us remember in a special way during this Mass, Fred Sankavage. Please stand. Our entrance hymn is number 352. Lord, move throughout this great place. 3, 5, 2. Meshach and Abednego, and cast them into the white-hot furnace.
Nebuchadnezzar rose in haste and asked his nobles, "Did we not cast three men bound into the fire?" "Assuredly, O king," they answered. "But," he replied, "I see four men, unfettered and unhurt, walking in the fire, and the fourth looks like a son of God." Nebuchadnezzar exclaimed, "Blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who sent his angel to deliver the servants who trusted in him. They disobeyed the royal command and yielded their bodies, rather than serve or worship any god except their own God." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory and praise forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. And blessed is your holy and glorious name, praiseworthy and exalted above all for all ages. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you in the temple of your holy glory, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you on the throne of your kingdom, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you who look into the depths from your throne upon the cherubim, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever.
Glory and praise forever.
Blessed are you in the firmament of heaven, praiseworthy and glorious forever.
Glory and praise forever.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to those Jews who believed in him, "If you remain in my word, you will truly be my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free." They answered him, "We are descendants of Abraham and have never been enslaved to anyone. How can you say you will become free?" Jesus answered them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, everyone who commits sin is a slave of sin. A slave does not remain in the household forever, but a son always remains. So if the son frees you, then you will be truly free. I know that you are descendants of Abraham, but you are trying to kill me, because my word has no room among you. I tell you that I have seen the Father's presence. Then do what you have heard from the Father." They answered and said to him, "Our father is Abraham." Jesus said to them, "If you were Abraham's children, you would be doing the works of Abraham. But now you are trying to kill me, a man who has told you the truth that I heard from God. Abraham did not do this. You are doing the works of your father." So they had said to him, "We are not born of fornication. We have one father, God." Jesus said to them, "If God were your father, you would love me, for I came from God, and I am here. I did not come on my own, but he sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Very, very young, like you are, they first learn fairy tales. And fairy tales are very simple. Maybe sometimes there's a king or queen or prince or princess. But there's always a good guy and a bad guy. Even in today's reading, we hear the names Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They were all servants of a wicked king. And these three men loved God, the one true God. And the king, he worshipped false gods. And he was very angry that anyone should worship anything or anyone other than his God, or his many gods. And so he decided he was going to punish these three young men. Not only punish them, torture them, burn them alive. And he told his guards to put them in a fiery furnace. And he told them to increase the heat 7 times so that they would suffer more. It's a horrible story, but a true story. And there are such evil people in the world today, many of them. But the good always outnumber the bad. And so at your age, whatever it is, you want to be a good guy, a good gal, whatever the case may be. Bad people are going to come to you. They're going to look good. They're going to talk good. They are manipulators. They will lie through their mouths, twist and turn their words, and make you believe that what they say is good for you. And the truth is, what they say is bad for you. And so in your lives, you're going to meet many, many bad people. And most of you already have met bad people. People who have hurt you. People who lie about you. People who will ignore you. Tell lies about you. Make fun of you. Bully you. There's too many to count. And this is going to go on throughout your life. But Jesus tells us to love our enemies, to love our neighbors, to love everybody. We know how hard it is to love someone who hurts badly. They say forgive and forget. But forgetting is very hard. Because in one way or another, when you're hurt, there's a scar. It might not be a physical scar, but it will be one that will scar you mentally. That will be on your memory for the rest of your lives. And we as Christians must rise above that. We have to pray for our enemies. Pray, do good for those who hurt you. So, at this stage of the game, and later on, you're just going to find it hard to forgive. Forgiving is hard work, but it's well worth it. Because when you forgive those who hurt you, you are the better person. You could go through life with a clear conscience. You can live in peace. And where do you get your strength to do this? You get it from Jesus. You ask for help. If you yourself have sinned, if you yourself have been the bad guy, you go to confession. Ask Jesus' help. Ask him to forgive you. You receive Holy Communion. Remember, Christ is all-powerful. And every time you go to Mass, every time you pray, you get strength. You become more beautiful in the sight of God. And others will love you, respect you, and want to be like you. So you have a choice. Be good. Be the good guy. The good gal. Or be the bad guy. And only God knows what happens to bad guys. And we have already been told. The future for them is not good. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Our hymn on the preparation of the gifts is number 390. My song is love unknown. In 390.
Amen. sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of his holy church.
Receive back, O Lord, these sacrificial offerings which you have given to be offered in honor of your name, and grant that they may become remedies for our healing. In Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sense of pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise, we acclaim. Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. Elizabeth of Hungary, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. May the mysteries we have just received, O Lord, bring us heavenly medicine, that they may purge all evil from our hearts, and strengthen us with eternal protection through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Bow down for the blessing.
Attend, Almighty God, to the prayers of your people, and as you endow them with comfort and hope in your compassion, let them feel, as ever, the effects of your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. Saint Michael the Archangel, who saved us in battle, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him when humbly pray, and to thou, Prince of Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits, the proud of the world, speaking in the most holy.